Right, I've woken up, and the first thing I'm doing is this. There was a lot of rain in that set. Group B and Das Hammer. Yeah, those two are crap. Yeah, I've quite literally woken up, turned on computer, got grinding. It's not an addiction, I promise. I just have things to do today. I don't want to get as many of these done as possible, so fucking around when there's literally nothing happening. Sounds a bit like a dumb idea. Always forget that corner because I can see the road ahead. We'll be right back. That was clean. this little top 100 there. Top 100 in Group B is lovely. Now time for the big one. Hello, Abyssal Sun. Hello, hello, hello. How is it going? Oh, God. Always brutal when you get a gear shift. In the freeze time between the thing. Thank you very much for the follow. Very much appreciated this fine morning. You browsing R34, there's a good chance you're gonna see some horrible stuff. I'd say occupational hazard right there. Yeah, you never... That is what Rule 34 is. Okay, that's... yeah, that's... grim, but... you probably shouldn't be looking up Rule 34 if you don't want to see some weird shit. Oh yeah, they do. You're just randomly browsing something completely off catches you. Especially when things are mistagged things. That goes for anything porn or normal videos, but you're just like browsing and something's completely mistagged, and sometimes it's funny and sometimes it's not. You might get an ad, you might not. It seems to be a bit random at the minute. So if you didn't get one, congratulations. The ad messages are also automated. I should run them off the bot account, but the bot account keeps crashing and disconnecting from the program I'm using, so it's easier to just keep one account going if they're both going to crash every couple of days. It's a pain in the ass. Bot accounts seem to crash way more though. Hoping they can fix that, because it used to work really well, but then Twitch changed some of their API stuff. So do you play much Art of Rally? Or what brings you to this end of Twitch? Ah, fair. Yeah. Oh, Rally is a very... oh shit, there's a stein on the inside. That corner's so brutal when you've got the crowd turned on. Because you think you can go through, but there's a stein on the inside. It kind of guides you around with the hay bale, saying the hay bale's the closest on the inside, and then boom! Gravestone. Yeah, Art of Rally, other than crashing into Hinkelsteins, but they are not part of the road, so if you stay on the road, there's no problem. That was the worst Sebastian Loeb impression anyone has ever done. I can't picture Smoliv. But that seems like the sort of shit that could potentially devolve here sometimes. Depends who's in. But there's usually like two people in. I do a monthly stream where I review all the world records from a racing game called Xenotic. Well, it's a Quake-like shooter, but there's a racing game mode in it. I review all the world records from the month, and quite often, there's just large swathes of... There's not much to say about the records, because some of them are genuinely impressive, but they are just... They are just slight shavings off of the last world record, or unless you really study them, which when there's already 2.5 hours of records to go through each month, I ain't got time for that, unless somebody tells me to, you know, someone gives me a reason to look at it deeply, I do. But yeah, those streams sometimes end up accidentally devolving into debating the meaning of life, the universe and everything. Well, there just so happens to be some gameplay going on in the background. I try to keep it as far from reaction content as possible. But I've got to be honest, it is just an excuse for me to watch all the world records. Because it does feel a bit sad, sat in your bedroom, on your own. Yeah, I mean, I get more viewers when I stream at better times. But, I mean, those followers are spread out over 10 years I've been here. You know, and I've done it for every game. So Art of Rally, not a very popular game, but in 2012 streaming Minecraft. That goes hard. Get a few viewers streaming what I just was talking about, the world record recaps, because, you know, invite the community in while I'm doing that. But these streams where I just turn the stream on and see who turns up, because realistically I'm only streaming because I need the video proof of what I'm doing, and because it's fun to sometimes people come and hang out. So I'd otherwise just be listening to music or watching a stream while I was doing this. I've got a Discord account, but I don't have like a Discord group or anything like that. I'm in the Art of Rally Discord if you actually play Art of Rally and join that. I don't see the point in having a Discord group for, this stream, because it's so disjointed who's around. I don't really see there being a community of the stream, because there'll be different people each day. So, you know, you're here for a racing game. You might come back tomorrow when I'm playing this, but there's a chance, good chance, that you won't turn up if I start playing TF2. And the same thing for the people who are here for Xenotic or Defrag. They ain't turning up for this. And I don't have enough of a schedule or for it to really matter to have that sort of thing. Alright, fair play. have a good night, and yeah, hopefully see you at some point when I'm streaming at not ridiculous hours. So yeah, cheers for stopping by. I'm surprised that didn't give me a cut, actually. Final stage. Ah, shit. Final stage with Das Hammer. All three dust hammers now. full gas into the finish. You beauty. 1,000! Bloody hell. Everyone's run that stage then. Everyone and their grandma's run that stage. Nice one. Right. 36, 22, 3, 75. Cheers, Turbo.